In this video, we will learn how to install the current version of MySQL on Windows 10. Let us start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type MySQL and press enter. The official website is visible, mysql.com. Click on it. Here is the official website. Click the downloads menu. After that, go below. Click MySQL Community Downloads. Under MySQL Community Downloads, click MySQL Installer for Windows. Here the current version is visible and it automatically selected the operating system. Here two versions can be seen. We will go for the second one, that is 354 MB. It's written x86 32-bit, but this works for 64-bit Windows operating system also. So just click on the download button. Now click no thanks, just start my download. The download started, let's wait. We have downloaded the MySQL installer file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started. Here you need to choose a setup type. I'll go for custom. Click next. Now select the products you want to install. So I'll click MySQL servers. Click MySQL server. Click MySQL server 8.0. Select the following. That is the current version. And click the arrow to drag it here. Now we have dragged it. So this is what we will install. After that, click applications. Click MySQL Workbench. Click MySQL Workbench 8.0. Here is the current version. Click the arrow to drag it. In the last, select MySQL Shell. MySQL Shell 8.0. Click MySQL Shell 8.0.43. After that, click here to drag it. Now we are installing all these three versions. Click next. Ready to install, click execute. Now it will install one by one. Let us wait. Here status is complete. Click next. Click next. Type and networking is visible. The port number is the following 3306. Click next. Authentication method, keep the default, that is use strong password. It's written recommended. Click next. Set a password. Here you need to create a password for root. Root means admin. So this should be your password. Okay. I'm repeating it again for some users who are unable to understand. You need to remember this password so that we can easily log in to our server later on. Click next. Windows service, keep it as it is and click next. Here server file permissions are visible. This is the place where your databases will get saved. Keep the default, that is yes, grant full access. Click next. Apply configuration. Click execute. Now let's wait. As you can see here, the configuration is successful. Click finish. Now click next. Now when I'll click finish, it will open MySQL Workbench and Shell. Click finish. Here it is, Shell and Workbench. Let us minimize because we need to set the path. Go to the place where we installed MySQL. It was in C drive, program files. Here it is. Click MySQL. MySQL Server 8.0. Click on the bin folder. Copy the path. Minimize. Let's go to start. Type environment variables. Under edit the system environment variables. Click open. Click environment variables. Now go to system variables. Here double click on path. Click new and paste the same path. Right click paste. We have pasted the bin path. Click OK. OK. And the last OK. Now we have installed MySQL. Let us verify. Go to start. Type cmd. Click open. Type the command MySQL space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. The following is visible. That means we successfully installed it. Now let us close this and open a new command prompt. Go to start. Type cmd. Click open. Now we will start the MySQL server. For that type MySQL hyphen u, use for user. User was root, if you remember, the default admin user. Type hyphen p and press enter. Now you need to enter the same password which we created before and press enter. So we have started our MySQL for the first time. Now let us create a new database. First we will display all the default databases using the show databases command, semicolon and press enter. Here are the default four databases. Now let us create a database using create space database space the database name. Here add any name for your database. I'll just add AmitDB to create a demo database. Press enter. One row affected means we successfully created it. Now when I'll use the command show databases, it will show five databases. Type the command show databases semicolon and press enter. Now we have our AmitDB database also. So for a free MySQL tutorial, refer to the link in the description of the video. Okay. Now let us minimize this and open the workbench from here. This is a UI to work with MySQL. It's written here. Click local instance and add the same password which we created before. Save in vault. Click OK. Now we have opened MySQL workbench. You can also create databases, tables and perform other operations here. For a free MySQL workbench tutorial also, refer to the link in the description of the video.